Greetings. If you are Muslim, I invite you to watch this whole video. We are examining scripture harmonization. And specifically, we are examining the scriptures that describe the Comforter. In the last video, I read four passages of text. John 14 verses 16 through 18, John 14 verses 24 through 27, John 15, 23 through 27, and John 16, 6 through 15. The thing that saddens me is that most Christians have probably never bothered to even read those four passages as a self-study. If you would, and paid attention and took notes as you did, you would know how to answer Islam when it makes its claim. For example, besides Comforter, what other names does Jesus supply? John 14:26, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost. John 15:26, but when the Comforter is come, even the Spirit of Truth, which proceeds from the Father. John 16:13, howbeit when He, the Spirit of Truth, is come. That is three direct references in four passages. And you should notice, every usage is the Greek word pneuma, meaning spirit or ghost. Not once is prophete, meaning prophet, used. We really should just decide that God is able to pick the word He wants to use. John 14:26, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, is Greek hagion pneuma. Hagion, which comes from hagios, is the Greek word meaning holy, that modifies pneuma. This is how we know the pneuma is more than just any ghost or spook. John 15:26, but when the Comforter is come, even the Spirit of Truth, which proceeds from the Father, pneuma tes aletheos, the Spirit of Truth that proceeds from, comes from, God. Howbeit when He, the Spirit of Truth, is come, pneuma tes aletheos. Jesus repeats this is a pneuma, or spirit, and does not use prophete. But you must realize, whether Christian or follower of Muhammad, someone with an agenda cannot afford honest examination. Such a person must contort and twist words to fit their agenda. Such a person with an agenda will claim you can have it fitting the focus of their agenda, the focus of their purpose, of their worship.
When you talk about spirit, you can have it fitting Muhammad. But when you say ghost, like a spook, it's very difficult to say Muhammad is a spook.
But you, dear viewer, you are able to hear the truth and choose the truth. Jesus clearly identifies the Comforter as a pneuma, meaning a spirit. Jesus even further calls this spirit holy and says it comes from God. Part of harmonization is to examine all the details of a topic and determine how those details should influence our thinking. Does Jesus say anything else which helps us know clearly who this holy pneuma is? Jesus says the Holy Spirit is invisible to the world. John 14:17, even the Spirit of Truth, whom the world cannot receive because it sees Him not, neither knows Him. Jesus says the disciples already know the Holy Spirit, but you know Him, for He dwells with you. That means the Comforter was already in the earth. What I find utterly amazing is just how hard Islam tries to argue the Comforter was not already in the earth. If you are Muslim, perhaps you can please explain what the following words mean. But you know Him, for He lives with you. if I said, "You know my brother because he lives with you," that should be easy and clear to understand. Likewise, Jesus speaking to his disciples, telling about the Comforter, says, "But you know him, for he lives with you." The word "know" is what we call present tense. It means now, and not sometime in the future, which has not happened yet. So it is the same exact meaning as saying, "But you already know him, for he lives with you." And that is a great puzzler. How can Muslims be so confused about so simple a text? Fundamentally, brother, it is because Muslims are not seeking the truth with honest eyes. I do not mean that as an insult, brother. It is an honest challenge for your benefit. All you have to do is listen clearly and think honestly. Jesus said the disciples already knew the Comforter. Therefore, the Comforter must be someone the disciples already knew. The Comforter must be someone already alive and present with them. But Islam's claim ignores this simple and clear logic and attempts to argue the opposite. Let me briefly lay out the Islamic argument, brother, because I understand it and I understand the error in it. It is based on one of the scriptures we aggregated, where Jesus says, "Jesus must go so Jesus can send the Comforter." John 16:7. "Nevertheless, I tell you the truth, it is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, or if I don't go away, the Comforter will not come unto you, but if I depart, I will send him unto you." There are two phrases in this verse which are just confusing enough for Islam to twist. "The Comforter will not come unto you." The phrase "will not come" can imply he is not yet there. And this is where harmonization comes into beneficial usage. Islam wants its whole argument to be based on "will not come," meaning he is not there yet. John 16:7, "For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you." But this ignores the other things that Jesus said about the Comforter. John 14:17, "But you know him, for he dwells," or lives, "with you already." Given an immature and disrespectful reading, one might accuse this as a contradiction. But you'd be wrong and foolish to do so, brother. There is, in fact, a completely logical and factual explanation. The key to understanding this is time, the time of each detail. "But you know him, for he dwells with you." When Jesus says this, it is present tense. It was already true when Jesus said it. "And shall be in you." Jesus says this in the future tense. "Shall be" means the condition or situation is in the future. When in the future? After Jesus sends the Comforter. Think about it, brother. For Islam to claim Muhammad is the Comforter means you must ignore Jesus' words. "But you know him, for he dwells, lives with you." 600 years before Islam even existed, this promise by Jesus was fulfilled. And the Christians knew it and walked daily with the proven knowledge of it. So aggregating and harmonizing the scriptures allows us to have all the details that describe and prove. The Comforter is the Holy Spirit of God, the third manifestation of the Trinity. If you are Muslim, perhaps you think I am inventing claims that Islam is not actually making. In the next video, I will gladly show you Didat making these very claims. with these very wrong arguments. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.